When Daryl, my agent, called me about the Wraith in January of 1986, oh, I was, what, 25 years old, and I had done a few movies, I played a few characters, but I saw this Rughead as an opportunity to really solidify myself as a full-blown character actor. You know, my hair had fallen out, and yet it seemed like they wanted me to have this eraser head hair. So I went in and auditioned. As it turns out, Mike Marvin later told me he had decided to use me the night before because he had seen this short film that Michael Keaton directed that I worked in with him. For it was on the David Letterman Film Festival. And Keaton just killed as a director, and he did a funny thing, and I was pretty good. And Mike saw it, and he knew I was going to play Rughead after that. So the cast got assembled. I was actually at the audition with, like, Chris and Griff, and I think Jamie was there. I think they had all the finalists there. And I remember packing a bag and getting ready to go to Tucson, and it was a big deal because, you know, still a young guy, hadn't been doing this on my own for too much time, and it felt like it was going to be a fun experience, and it was. It happens very rarely. It's happened to me twice where I've worked on a movie and created friendships that go way beyond just business. Apollo 13 was a wonderful example of that. I met some wonderful, wonderful friends. It was just a good time in my life. But also the Wraith. There was this collection of people, young people, Nick Cassavetes and Charlie was just a pup, and Chris Nash and Griffin O'Neill and Jamie Bosian and Dave Sherrill, and Johnny Depp is hanging out because he happens to be the boyfriend of Sherrilyn Fenn. So anyway, it was just this wonderful circus that us actors got to participate in for, oh, I don't know. I think I saw somewhere recently that they shot for 42 days, which, Jesus, that's a lot in this day and age. But we were there in Houston. In Tucson. And I do remember that that's when the Challenger crashed. That's, you know, time and a place when something happens in your life. It happened to be on the Wraith. I was gone. I had finished and wrapped and gone home. By the time there was the car wreck, or the camera truck spun out, and there was a death, and there's a couple of bad injuries, and I know it left a bad stain on Mike's brain, and it kind of tainted the movie a little bit. Anyway, the fun of working in Tucson with a gang like Charlie Sheen and Chris Nash and Jamie Bosian and Dave Sherrill. Oh yeah, and there's Nick Cassavetes. It was an all-timer. I'll never forget at the Holiday Inn cocktail lounge. There was a guy that had a one-man band thing going. It was, you know, he was the lounge lizard, and he had the drums, and he was a one-man band. And we finished work, and we wanted to go in and have a couple of cool adult beverages because we were adults at that time. And Charlie actually pulled out a $100 bill and asked this fellow if he wouldn't play because it was sort of annoying. And the guy thought about it. He almost took Charlie's money, but then he said he thought he'd probably get fired if he took the money. So Charlie, with a smile on his face, said he understood, and I think we went upstairs to his room. we had a time. Nick and I, a little older than Charlie, and there was one opportunity where it seemed like the window was going to be open to go to Las Vegas. Short flight from Tucson to Vegas. And so Nick and I probably had done it a few more times than Charlie. And we sort of scheduled a trip. And I know Nick likes to flip cards, and I like to see bones roll. And I know Charlie's hardly ever turned down any kind of a wagering opportunity. We went to Vegas, and we had a great time. And it was fun. And, you know, it was a little like Hangover. There was a time when I lost track of the fellas, and anyway, we get back on the plane and we come home, and it's Monday morning. Charlie was expecting to not have to work, and something had happened, and they had changed the schedule, and they had moved a fairly significant scene that Charlie was supposed to do right into that spot on Monday morning. And boy, oh boy, Charlie was a sick little boy. And he paid the price that day. Nick and I, we had the day off. We went right to bed. There's one more thing about the Wraith that always sort of bothered me a little bit. This John Kimmeny fellow, who was the producer, he really thought he was just the cat's meow, and he was the wizard of all wizards. And you know, he put this young cast together. We went to Tucson. And a few of us had inquired about seeing dailies, at which point John Kimmeny, everybody concerned, said, "Oh no, you can't see dailies. It's our policy not to show you dailies." Now, I'd been working in the business for about 25 years. You know, Nick was bred into the business. So is Charlie. I mean, come on. We want to see some dailies. Well, they wouldn't let us, so that wouldn't stop us. They were showing the dailies, and they weren't really dailies. I think they were weeklies. They would show them in the conference room of the Holiday Inn we were staying at. And we knew when they were going to be, and there was a few of us. I don't think it was the whole herd, but there was a few of us. I was there. We went inside the room, the conference room, underneath the tablecloths of the tables, and we watched dailies while the asshole adults were, you know, watching dailies. You know, listen, after about 30 seconds or a minute of seeing dailies, I'm fine. I'm ready to go. I'm just kind of curious to see how it's looking. So that was a case where the producers thought they knew best, and I think time lets them know that they were wrong. Great memories working on the Wraith, and my personal relationships with Jamie and Dave and Charlie and Nick. It's just one of those deals where when you get to be in the business and you get to have these experiences, it just reinforces how cool it is. Oh, and I can't forget, one of my idols as a young character actor was Randy Quaid. And he was one of the guys that I always wanted to work with. I mean, I saw him in Last Detail and I thought he just killed, and yeah. Okay, so he's going to be in the movie. So getting a chance to do a scene with Randy Quaid was a blast, and it was as good as I could possibly have dreamed it to be. We later worked again on a movie called The Paper, a thing that my brother did, but that was quite a few miles ago for Mr. Quaid, and hope all is well there. And boy, oh boy, it's nice every once in a while to stop and talk about the Wraith. Because, you know, even if you're a very successful actor, you're only going to have a handful of these movies in your life. And it's good to stop and smell the roses every once in a while.